Typical Hollywood story.
Damn good actress.
First thing you notice about Chaplin are his eyes. What he was able to say without words, what he was able to express without words, just in the tilt of the head or body language, says infinitely more than most actors can say in a five-page monologue. There are moments like in Limelight where he's just filled with electricity. What grabbed me, but as a seven-year-old waiting for the guy to speak, and then forgetting that he doesn't speak. He didn't need to speak. It was all there. I mean, a real master of emotion without a word uttered. It only takes editing now to make one a comic genius. Close-ups have saved people. Close-ups have made huge stars of people. What they did back then in a big wide master shot, I think it would be almost impossible for the majority of people to do today.
Today we pay tribute to the works of one of film's greatest actors, Charlie Chaplin, Monday at 6 a.m., only on Turner Classic Movies. Classic Movies presents Star of the Month, Rita Hayworth. 26 films, Tuesdays in April, beginning at 8 p.m. Completely commercial free on Turner Classic Movies.
This is Sunset Boulevard, Los Angeles, California. A murder has been reported in one of those great big houses in the 10,000 block. An old-time star is involved, one of the biggest. But before you hear it all distorted and blown out of proportion, maybe you'd like to hear the facts, the whole truth. The body of a young man was found floating in the pool of her mansion. Nobody important, really. The poor dope. He always wanted a pool.
I used to be afraid of that look. The withering glance of the goddess.
I didn't think that alcohol would... Oh, shut up.
Dinah, stay here.
Oh, please, Mother. Maybe he's going to soccer again.
It's what everybody feels about you. It's what I first worshipped you for from afar.
George, listen.
First, now, and always. Only from a little nearer now. Hey, darling?
I don't want to be worshipped. I want to be loved.
Someday over the rainbow, way up high.
What is this, Connor?
Oh, easy, easy, old man. She's not hurt?
No, no.
Not wounded, Saul, but dead.
Seems the minute she hit the water, the wine hit her.
Now, look here, Connor.
A likely story, Connor.
Hello, Dexter. Hello, George.
Hello, Mike.
You have a good mind, a pretty face, a disciplined body that does what you tell it. You have everything that it takes to make a lovely woman except the one essential. An understanding heart. And without that, you might just as well be made of bronze.
And the night that you got drunk on champagne and climbed out on the roof and stood there naked with your arms out to the moon, wailing like a banshee.
I told you I never had the slightest recollection of doing any such thing.
What in the name of all that's holy am I to do?
Tracy.
Yes, Mike.
Old Parson, he's never seen Kedridge before, has he? Now look, I got you into this thing, and I'll get you out of it. Will you marry me, Tracy?
To do the beginning of a song from Funny Face, in Funny Face, with Fred Astaire. And it was going to be shot on the Champs-Élysées with the Arc de Triomphe behind him. And we rehearsed, as I recall, with Fred Astaire in the hotel because I was afraid it would create such a mob scene we couldn't get the shot. So I told him he would arrive in a car and the car would stop at a particular place and he would get out and he would see a little mark on the pavement, and that would be where he was to start. When it all happened and Fred Astaire stepped out of the taxi and started to walk in rhythm and sing down the Champs-Élysées, it was a thrilling moment for me, and it still is.
I want to step out down the Champs-Élysées, from the Arch of Triumph to the Petit Palais, that's for me. Bonjour Paris.
We celebrate the life and works of legendary director Stanley Donen with Happy Birthday, Stanley Donen. Friday at 11 a.m. Only on Turner Classic Movies.
Robert Osborne. This has been a very special evening on TCM as we premiered a trio of films from the RKO Library, which haven't been seen in nearly 50 years. And as far as we can tell, our next film hasn't been seen in this country since it made its initial theatrical rounds back in 1938. So that means nobody's seen this movie in nearly 70 years. It's called A Man to Remember. It's a remake of a film that Merian C. Cooper executive produced for RKO in 1933, a film called One Man's Journey, which we showed on TCM last Wednesday. It starred Lionel Barrymore as a small-town doctor who eagerly goes to great lengths to tend to his patients. Well, Merian C. Cooper had acquired the copyright to that film and this remake as well as four other films, all part of a legal settlement in a contract dispute Cooper had with RKO Studios, a dispute that was finally resolved in 1946. Well, a few years later, television came onto the scene, and at that time, Cooper arranged for TV showings of five of the six RKO films. But the film we have for you next, The Man to Remember, was not part of that package, which is why nobody has seen it since it was initially shown in theaters. We have no idea why it wasn't included in that TV package, but one reason could be because Dalton Trumbo wrote the screenplay. And at that point in time, Trumbo had been blacklisted in Hollywood because of the infamous House Un-American Activities Committee hearings looking into communists who may be working in the film industry. Trumbo had refused to confirm or deny that he was ever a member of the Communist Party. Now, there's no proof of his being involved with this film or those hearings had anything to do with what happened to this film, but it's very possible. It could also be the reason no print of the film was part of Cooper's archives at Brigham Young University. The other five RKO films were all kept there, not this one. In order to bring you the print we're going to show you right now of A Man to Remember, we had to go to Holland and the Netherlands Film Museum, which had a 35mm nitrate print in English, but with Dutch subtitles. And that's the version we have for you next. Hope you enjoy it. From 1938 and starring Anne Shirley, Lee Bowman, and in the role played in the original by Lionel Barrymore, Edward Ellis. Here's A Man to Remember.